Lanesh requested combos here, some combo attacks. First, let me just show you what I have. I'm not aiming for extreme juggles like Tekken where it's 1v1 with lots of HP. If you remember those stick figure kung fu fighting animations where it's 1v many, I'm more focusing on multiple attack transitions and using ragdolls to cause collateral damage. In this case, most enemies other than the bosses barely have any HP, and even though they drop like flies, there's a lot of them and you can cycle through multiple attacks in one flow to kill many. So my free version in the public repository uses Mixamo animations, and the version in my private folder uses animations from the Unity Asset Store, in this case the Frank RPG Fighter. The basic mechanics have always been the same. I use the animator in humanoid animations, I've seen some indiegame developers using generic animation for human character models, and I must say that's not a good idea. There's multiple reasons, but for this video let me just stick to the idea that humanoid avatars allow animations to be used across all humanoid characters, whereas that's simply not possible with generic animations. They're good for unique individual avatars like dragons or multi-legged creatures that have non-human bone structures, but for humanoids, humanoid animations are usually a good fit. If you click on one of these animator states, you'll see that I have something attached to it, the character state. The character state is a class inherited from one of Unity's default classes, the StateMachineBehaviour. The StateMachineBehaviour is a class that you can attach to animator states, in a similar way that you can attach model behaviors to game objects. By attaching a state machine behavior to an animator state, you can have a script that updates only when a specific animation is playing. The most common functions that I use in this class are onStateEnter, onUpdate, and onStateExit. If you're used to state machines, you know that these are very common ways to control a state. onStateEnter gets called in the beginning of the animation, onUpdate gets called every frame while the animation is playing, onStateExit gets called as you exit the animation. So by inheriting from the state machine behavior, the character state gets to use all of these functions while being able to add more. Each character state has a list of what I call abilities. Every time onStateEnter, onUpdate, or onStateExit is called, the entire list of abilities is updated. An ability could be move, register attacks, jump, or make transitions, and so on. The air combo launch, for example, has 5 abilities. Ground detector for detecting ground, jump will launch the player into the air, move forward will make the player move forward, attack will register an attack at a certain time, and instant transition will trigger a transition to the next part of the combo under certain conditions. Right now I only have 2 attacks that are linked together, but by using the same workflow, I can link up as many attacks as I want. If I look at the attack ability, in the beginning of every attack, I get a game object from the pool. You should already know what the concept of pooling is, but let me know if you want me to do a tutorial on it. Anyways, I get a game object with a script called attack condition. It defines whether the attack is registered or finished or how many targets are already hit, etc., the current status basically. The attack ability, on the other hand, defines things like when the attack should be registered or deregistered, how much force it should have on the rigid body, and so on. For example, you might want the attack to have impact at a certain point in the animation. Or, after a certain percentage of the animation, you no longer want the attack to be valid. Or, some attacks will launch the ragdoll into the air, while some will push the ragdoll straight back. In summary, the attack ability contains the definition of the attack, and the attack condition contains the current status of the attack on a particular frame. By looking at these 2 types of info, plus the collision info, we can determine whether an attack has hit the target or not. Whenever there's collision between my body and some object, I compare the 2 info, and if they match, that's a valid attack. Now the question becomes, how do you detect collision? If you look at the character, you'll notice a bunch of colliders. These are set up using the ragdoll wizard, or you can set them up manually if you want to. But once you do set them up, whenever there's contact between that collider and another object with a rigid body and collider, you can see it in code. For example, here's a callback function, onTriggerEnter, that gets called whenever something touches a collider. This function only works if you check the isTrigger box. If you uncheck it, you can use onCollisionEnter. The difference between a trigger and a non-trigger is that a trigger does not interact with the colliding object physically, while a non-trigger does. You'll notice that while a character is alive, all colliders are triggers, but when a character is dead, all colliders are switched to non-triggers, which turns them into a ragdoll. This is because I want live character movement to be controlled by animations, but ragdoll to be controlled by other physical objects or velocity. Some games use both at the same time because animations can be interrupted or altered by collisions, but for simplicity, for this project, I differentiate the two. So under a list of colliders called body parts, I store all colliders of a character, and whenever other character body parts come into contact and onTriggerEnter is called, I look at the attack ability, the attack condition, and decide whether I should take damage or not. Now I can have as many combos as I want. Through a transition ability, I decide which animation should come next, and through an attack ability, I decide how the attack affects the target or when the attack should be valid. But of course, there's drawbacks. For example, I have blending between the end of the current animation and the start of the next animation. This means that before OnStateExit is called, OnStateEnter from the next animation is called. This will sometimes result in your data not matching your animation. If you're not careful with your scripts or transitions, it's likely that you're going to have unexpected or undesired results. If you make zero blending between transitions, the transition becomes much more clear-cut, but you won't get the smoothness in between. I might have other issues like dynamically changing ragdoll paths. Depending on which part of the attack animation the target is hit, I could or should have different directions that the ragdoll flies to. Details like this I haven't implemented yet, and they'll come later on, but for now I'm happy with this system of linking animations, transitions, and attack info. The collateral damage coming from flying ragdolls is just detecting collisions and turning the live character into a dead ragdoll. Once you set up a general pattern, the rest is just scripting and moving data around. If you don't have programming experience, there's a good chance that you can get caught up in syntax or get extremely confused because you're unable to see the big picture, which is why I always say learn to code before Unity. There's a lot of info in scripts that I didn't explain in this video because there's so many moving parts, and it's more efficient to simply leave the project open source and let you see it for yourself. But if you're confused about a particular subject, let me know and I can explain more. You can reach me on my Discord server, all links are below, or you can leave comments if you want to. I saw one of you asking about crossfade, so I'll talk about that in the next couple of videos. I'll talk about root motion because that's related, and then talk about crossfade. For now, I'm going to end this video here. By switching to ragdoll physics, you can see the difference between the current version and the older version I made a long time ago. So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.